We've got a few footnotes and an endnote inside of your Microsoft Word document. And we saw when you create footnotes, those items that show up at the bottom of the page where that keyword is found, they format them using numeric values. 1, 2, 3, however many footnotes you've got. And endnotes, they don't use the numeric values or the numeric representation, but they're using Roman numerical values, I, and so on, to be able to denote the variety of endnotes that you may have within the document. Now, if you want to change the formatting, the way that these footnotes and endnotes are referenced or they're identified, we can get into the formatting options of your footnotes and your endnotes. Take a look. So just to remind you, I've got footer there, number one. I've got galleries, number two. And I've got reading view as the endnote. And it's got the lowercase I there. And I can see those being referenced inside of the footnote as well as the endnote. Now I want to change that. Perhaps I want to use different characters to represent my footnotes and my endnotes. So I'm going to go back up to my References tab, back into Footnotes, and I'm going to go into this little button in the corner. Looks like a little right angle with an arrow. So I'll get into that, I'll give that a click. So it opens up my Footnote and Endnote option window. And here you can see that it's currently looking at my endnotes. So it's going to show up, one, the location at the end of the document. Makes sense. You can also, if you've got larger documents with lots of sections in them, remember talking about sections way back when, way inside the first area of this training series, we can have them show up at the end of a section. I'll keep it at the end of the document. You can set up columns, so you can have multiple columns that'll have you show up inside of the footnote or endnote section. You might be cramming a lot of information inside there. I've seen this pretty popular inside of textbooks. Got a lot of little footnotes that are covering up a page. I'm going to break them up into a variety of columns, make it more manageable for me. And I can change the format. So endnotes, remember Roman numerical values, I can get in and I can change it. Perhaps I want to do ABC lowercase or uppercase and so on. Perhaps I want to use different symbols. I see the different symbols used quite a bit when you're looking at legal documents. And you see a little asterisk or a little plus sign or whatever the symbol may be, and it references something at the bottom of the document. So let me just change one. I'm going to do the lowercase ABC. I'll go ahead and apply it. And there it is, the letter A. It's now inside of my endnote. And if I go find the corresponding value there, reading view, there's the lowercase A. Really small inside there. You can probably see it much better on your screen. But try this out, doing a little bit of formatting. You can even do it with your footnotes as well. I'll place my cursor down there inside the footnote area, go back to references, get into that little button in the corner again. Now I'm looking at footnotes. They show up at the bottom of the page by default, and I can get in there and start to format them, perhaps differently than what the default behaviors are inside of Microsoft Word. So try this out. Get into your document, references, go to that little button in the corner, a little right angle with the arrow, and try changing the formatting of your footnotes and your endnotes.